Archery is one of the oldest sports known to man. It has built empires, taken down armies, and still to this date, remains a very popular and well-heeled sport. The earliest people are known to have regularly used bows and arrows were the ancient Egyptians, who adopted archery around 3000 BC for hunting and warfare. The objective of the game is simple enough: to hit a target, preferable to the center of the target as much as possible. In the Olympics, competitors aim at a target from a distance of 70 meters, and rounds include a ranking round where the overall scores determine the athlete's rankings prior to a head-to-head elimination format. As per the rules of the game from the World Archery Foundation, the specifics of the equipment entail: a bow of any type, provided it complies with the common meaning of the word bow as used in target archery, that is, an instrument consisting of a handle, riser and grip, no shoot through type riser, and two flexible limbs each ending in a tip with a string nock. The bow is braced for use only by a single string attached directly between the two string nocks, and in operation is held in one hand by its handle grip, while the fingers of the other hand draw and release the string. A bowstring of any number of strands, which may be of multi-colored strands and serving, and of the material chosen for the purpose. It may have a center serving to accommodate the drawing fingers, one or two nocking points to which may be added servings to fit the arrow nock as necessary, and to locate the nocking points. At each end of the bowstring, there is a loop which is placed in the string nocks of the bow when braced. In addition, one attachment is permitted on the string to serve as a lip or nose mark. The serving on the string shall not end within the athlete's vision at full draw. The bowstring shall not in any way assist aiming through the use of a peephole, marking, or any other means. Arrows of any type may be used, provided they comply with the common meaning of the word arrow as used in target archery, and do not cause undue damage to target faces or butts. An arrow consists of a shaft with a tip, point, nocks, fletching, and if desired, cresting. The maximum diameter of arrow shafts shall not exceed 9.3 mm. Arrow wraps shall not be considered as part of this limitation, but may not extend further than 22 cm toward the arrow point when measured from the nock groove where the bowstring sits to the end of the wrap. The tips points of the arrow may not exceed 9.4 mm in diameter. All arrows of every athlete shall be marked with the athlete's name or initials on the shaft. All arrows used in any end shall be identical in appearance and shall carry the same pattern and color S of fletching, nocks, and cresting if any. Tracer nocks, electronically lighted nocks, are not allowed. There are a few more specifics regarding finger pads, risers and braces, and the use of bow sights, scopes, binoculars, and eyeglasses, bow stabilizer in the game, which you will find in thorough detail in the website of the World Archery Foundation, which I highly recommend you check out. The target itself varies considerably in size, ranging from those used in Olympic archery events that measure 122 centimeters in diameter, but all contain 10 concentric rings which represent the different scoring sectors. The outermost two rings, called one ring and two rings, are white, 3 and 4 are black, 5 and 6 are blue, 7 and 8 are red, and 9 and 10, the innermost rings, are gold. 10 rings also has an inner ring, known as inner 10, or X ring, which is sometimes used to decide ties. From outside to inside, the points range from 1 for the outermost ring to 10 for the two innermost rings, and of course, arrows completely missing the target get no score at all. Athletes cannot shoot in groups more than 3. In individual competitions, 3 arrows per target will be shot in all rounds, and in 3D rounds, 2 arrows per target will be shot in the qualification rounds, 1 arrow per target will be shot in elimination and final rounds. For teams, 3 arrows per team shall be shot at each target in all rounds, 1 arrow by each team member. At the first target, the higher-ranked team decides who shall start shooting. Thereafter, the team with the lower cumulative score will shoot first at the following target, and, if the teams are tied, then the team which started the match will shoot first. Add up the points achieved, whether by the individual or the team, and you've got your score. Tournaments vary considerably in format and the number of arrows competitors must shoot and the distance to the target, so it will be up to decide on the format of your games and tournament. To win the game, you or your team must either have the highest cumulative score on the field, or in a knockout version of the tournament, you must have successfully defeated all your opponents to be declared the victor. In the event of a tie, the shooter with the highest number of inner tens is declared the winner. or you can opt for a shootout to resolve the tie.